On the home stretch, guys, last again, condiment slash sauce, however you want to look at it. Let's talk a little bit about this kale pistachio pesto. So, fresh kale. This is baby lacinato kale. Much, much easier to work with, especially for this preparation. We have some pistachios. You can, if it's up to you, entirely up to you. If you want to toast them off, either in the oven or on a dry saucepan, you can do that. I gave these a little bit of toast. It kind of brings out more of the nuttiness of that pistachio. Fresh garlic. Parmesan cheese. And we have some olive oil. So extra virgin olive oil. We don't want to use, say, regular olive oil in this or regular oil, because we really want to impact as much flavor as possible. So we have 5 items to make this pesto. Let's talk just briefly about pesto for a second. I think most of us are probably pretty familiar with the typical pesto, the Italian version of pesto, which is a Genovese dish, basil, pine nuts, olive oil, garlic, Parmesan cheese, etc. Oftentimes, when you'll find commercial pestos, they won't have pine nuts. Pine nuts are incredibly expensive. They will either not have a nut in there at all, or they might substitute walnuts for the nut in a commercial pesto. Anyway, let's move on to the food processor. So we're going to start with the garlic and the pistachios. Get those going for a second. Pulse a few times. So get this process going. Okay, how much texture do you want in your pesto? You want it to be incredibly smooth, or are you happy with a little bit of texture in it? I like texture, so. That's pretty good to me. Let's add in all of our kale. Kale is the substitute for what herb for general pasta or general pesto? That's right, you got that right, of course. That would be fresh basil. Let's get that down for a second or two. Looking good. I'm gonna take a picture of that inside right there for a second. There we go. All right, let's go to add the Parmesan cheese. We can add a little bit of salt and some pepper at this point. Then, let's grab our olive oil here. We can start with some before we put the top back on, just to get it going, give it a little paste quality. Bring it on and we'll let that go. Adding some olive oil to it, won't need much. That's looking good. I want to scrape the sides of the bowl down for a second. Let's give that a taste. Remember, the cheese has a kind of a salty quality to it. We did add a little salt and pepper to it. Mm, wow. Boy, that is delicious again. I'm outdoing myself with these last few sauces. So that's ready to go. Oh man, actually tastes the pistachios, which is good. So now what we want to do is we want to plate this dish. All right, so what we're gonna do is we take the crostini. Before we put it onto the plate there, we're gonna, excuse me, before we put the plate on, or before we put the crostini on the plate, we want to dress it up first in this pan and then move it over to the plate that we're going to display it on. So we'll take some white beans. So it doesn't matter how messy this procedure gets right here, because nobody's going to see that. Now you'll have enough baguette for at least this many crostini. Is it 2, 4? That's 6. Yeah, you'll have enough baguette for at least that. And the white beans will last quite a while in the refrigerator. The pesto will last quite a bit, quite a while in the refrigerator also. Oop, that one got out of the way. So let's go ahead and add this to that mixture right there. That was just right here. Now, if you want to, it's up to you. I don't know if I'm going to be sending enough cheese necessarily, but you can certainly sprinkle some Parmesan cheese on top, or you can alternate the cheeses if you like. You can put Manchego cheese on there, and also in the preparation if you wanted to, Asiago. I think any hard cheese, a Pecorino, Romano. These will all be gone, believe me, between my wife and myself. They'll all be gone for sure. So there we have the white bean crostini with a kale and pistachio pesto. That's it for this section. I will load these videos tonight and actually get them uploaded to my Canvas shell tomorrow at some point. I will like to mention that the food bags will definitely be ready by 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. So check your Canvas for any kind of notifications. I'll also try to send it through an email as well. So looking forward to your next batch of production, guys. Thanks very much for your patience. Bye.